Hope you all had a great holiday. Even though many of us have been taking vacations or visiting family, the news never stops. New product announcements from GALAX, launch dates for the Ryzen 7000 non-X series, and so much more. Let's talk about it right here on Robeytech. If you watched the last news episode of Robeytech, you know that GALAX revealed the bonkers, and I do mean bonkers, RTX 4090 HOF or Hall of Fame edition. And it looks like they aren't done with the lineup, not by a long shot. This week, we saw the announcement of two products to join the Hall of Fame. While there aren't any details beyond what we mentioned here, like a price or anything like that, we can expect them to be beefy and also spendy. The first, an option of a 1 terabyte or 2 terabyte SSD, the HOF Extreme 50. The latter of the two, the 2 terabyte version, GALAX claim has a read speed of 10 gigabytes per second and a write speed of 9.5 gigabytes per second, which is madness, guys. That is absolutely crazy. But that isn't going to be their fastest, since GALAX stated that they only have another SSD coming in very soon that will hit read speeds of 12. Holy cow. Now, each SSD has a built-in enclosure slash heat sink, complete with a built-in fan for active cooling, which I guess you need. Hey, more fans, the better. They have their own built-in DDR4 cache and uses a 232-layer NAND flash memory and fission controller. Now, the next product they revealed is their Hall of Fame Pro DDR5 memory lineup that will be available in a few configurations, from 6,800 megatransfers per second up to 8,000 megatransfers per second in 2x16 cents. So, not the first to 8,000. I mean, we got G-Skill, and I know Giel just announced theirs, but, you know, it's good to see that they got this one going. Regardless, all this stuff is crazy and absolutely bonkers, and to see them adding DDR5 and those ridiculous, looks like Gen 5 NVMe drives is bonkers. Now, like we said earlier, no more information is available on these, and the products don't even have like their own listings on the website as of right now, but they do look pretty. The RAM looks absolutely sweet, with like that signature Hall of Fame crown with RGB strips along the top and a thin band of light on the side. They look clean and would be right at home with like the 4090 we showed last week. If only, you know what, we could get those in the US, but alas, we cannot, unless you look on eBay and are willing to pay like 10 times the amount. Next up, it looks like Sonic isn't done going fast, except this time they're gonna go fast on a budget. See, ASROCK debuted their Z790 Sonic motherboard to much acclaim not too long ago with their official license board partnership with, of course, Sega. But for most people, the jump to the new platform was too expensive. Now, ASRock and Sega are working on the release of a B760M motherboard that has the same overall theme and design as the Big Brother counterpart, but this time in a micro ATX form factor, and of course cheaper. It will have the same support for DDR5, it'll have Gen 5, but the B760M iteration will ship with a Wi-Fi network card, which the Z790 did not. See, it uses the same dual 8-power pin connectors, which, I mean, sure, if we can ever overclock on a B760. It's got practically identical I/O and VRM heat sinks, so form factor aside, it's pretty nearly the same motherboard, minus the fact that it's a B760M. So if you missed out on the Z790 version of it, and you know, also it was maybe a little bit outside of your price range, fear not, because you'll have another chance to get your hands on everyone's favorite speedy hedgehog and collect all the chaos emeralds with your new rig whenever it comes out. Now, there's no pricing available since this is just an image that we found, but we'll let you know as soon as we find out. So, it's nice to have a story like this because we've been following this now for a while, but over the last few weeks, we've slowly been seeing more and more information leak out from official AMD slides with pieces of information about the upcoming non-X lineup of their Ryzen 7000 series CPUs. We got three models currently slated for release. We got the 6-core 7600, an 8-core 7700, and a 12-core 7900, all with pricing from $229 up to $429, like we reported earlier. Now, we know it's releasing on January 10th, so pretty soon to after you're probably gonna watch this video, and very quickly in the new year. But finally, we'll be able to test everything side by side to see if it's worth it, just spending a little bit of extra money on the X version and allowing you to do the overclocking. Sure, right now a lot of the X versions are on sale with Amazon, selling from anywhere from like 13 to 20% off, so you could get them for roughly $20 more, which feels like the X is gonna be a better thing at that price, but we'll have to see, because that's the sale price, and obviously that's not gonna last forever, and we don't know if there will be any any sales incentives or bundles with these new CPUs that are coming out of the gate right when they drop. But aside from the clock speeds for the non-X still not being any slouch when you compare boost clocks, the main draw for this lineup is the lower power consumption, and that means less heat. With the TDP coming in at only 65 watts for each SKU, that's a lot of power that uses a lot less power, and that could be a good thing. Continuing in the CPU news, Asus has managed to break their own overclocking record and possibly a world record of overclocking with the i9-13900K. On liquid nitrogen, Asus had previously pulled out a whopping 8.8 gigahertz, with the freezing juice dropping temps to roughly negative 196 degrees Celsius. To go beyond their limits, they made the swap from liquid nitrogen to liquid helium. For those who don't know, and you know what, honestly, I didn't until I kind of read up on how they managed to do this, but liquid helium gets as cold is negative 269 degrees Celsius, which is only 4 degrees warmer, if you want to call it that, than absolute zero, which is like when all molecular motion stops. So what they did is this let them crank the output of the i9 to an insane 9 gigahertz boost clock. Now this record will likely stand for a while, or at least until someone else tries a similar method and somehow pulls out a fraction of performance to eke out the attempt by Asus. Either way, this is an incredible feat with incredible technology and super impressive to be pulled off. Now when it comes to gaming news, the last weeks of December are pretty sparse, considering the Game Awards have already happened and that's like the big marketing moment for everyone at the end of the year. But Escape from Tarkov fans were treated to a present of their own with a 2-minute trailer for the 0.13 patch that showed off the highly anticipated Streets of Tarkov location, and it looks absolutely amazing. On top of the new apocalyptic environment you'll be playing in, they've added a handful of new weapons to their sandbox, and all the long-term fans of the series are ecstatic and cannot wait to get their hands on it and jump in for themselves. Now, there's no ETA, as the trailer didn't have like a release date or anything like that, but as soon as we get any information, I'm sure we'll let you know. Now, it's become like commonplace in the World Wide Web for like those end of the year wrap-ups, like things like overviews of what you listen to on Spotify, watched on Twitch. But now we've got a fresh new look at what Steam's end of year replay, and it looks, you know what, it's pretty awesome. And it's cool to see, you know, that this kind of wrap up. So they've got like tiles that break down like your most played game, how many times you've played it, and what percentage of your total time playing was that particular title. And also it shows you like how many games you played, what new games you finally jumped into, achievement unlocks, and the longest streak for basically playing every day. So we thought it'd be cool if we like shared our Steam replay highlights, and you can let us know in your comments below what's your most played game of 2022 was. And you know what? Sure, go ahead and link them or tag me on Twitter over at Robeytech and share it with me. Anyway, guys, that is it for news this week. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below. How badly do you want GALAX Hall of Fame any of their product lineup? Are you thinking about getting like that ASROCK Sonic B760M board? Do you play Tarkov? And how long have you been waiting to like be a part of the Streets of Tarkov beta? And what is your most played game of 2022? Let us know that all down in the comments below. So while you're down there, why don't you go ahead and tap that like and subscribe button, you know, the one that's right there, and you know what, turn on notifications so you don't miss another video just like this. Also, be sure to check out our live streams, either here on YouTube or over at twitch.tv/Robeytech every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday, starting at 5 p.m. Pacific time. And before you go, you know what, why not head over to your favorite social media platform and give us a follow? We're on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, Facebook. You know what, we're there at Robeytech absolutely everywhere. And you also should join our Discord, discord.gg/Robeytech, where tens of thousands of tech and PC enthusiasts love to hang out and talk about news and tech and builds and all that sort of stuff. And you know what, you actually might make a friend. Anyway, guys, that's it for us. Thank you for watching, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.